Queen said tonight they were planning a big musical event dedicated to their lead singer, Freddie Mercury, who died last night of AIDS. There have been tributes to his talent and his courage from friends and from fans. The Health Minister, Mrs. Virginia Bottomley, predicted his death would have a big impact in preventing the spread of AIDS.
One of the most flamboyant rock stars of his generation, Freddie Mercury was extravagant in everything he did. God knows, God knows I've fallen in love. I'm just a fool. With early hits like Bohemian Rhapsody, he and Queen created a whole new medium. The pop video was born. He was also a master of the big event, drawing crowds to live shows all over the world. In his private life, he made no secret of his love affairs with both men and women.
He lived his private life as passionately and flamboyantly as he did his open professional life. And in that sense, this is a tragic consequence, but it's something which, for him, was inevitable.
He'd known for 2 years that he had AIDS, but had kept it quiet, living the life of a recluse in his £5 million mansion in West London, where fans have been paying their tributes. He only admitted publicly that he had AIDS the day before he died, when he also appealed to his fans to help combat the disease.
I do think that the death of somebody who's been so admired and has been such a hero in some respects does have a very profound impact. Last week we had the death of Tony Richardson, the announcement from Magic Johnson. And I believe that that does reach out and communicate, perhaps with youngsters who may not otherwise have really thought through how serious this is.
I will now become a spokesman for the HIV virus.
The announcement by basketball star Magic Johnson that he was retiring from the game because he was HIV positive won him universal praise. Because he spoke out to help others, he was also heterosexual. Not only was Freddie Mercury homosexual, but he kept his illness from his public until the last moment.
We should remember him for his music and not for his health and his AIDS diagnosis. So I think he was right to keep that private. I'm glad that towards his death, he recognized the important role he could have in informing other people, warning other people of the dangers of AIDS. So I think he got it right.
Despite his crippling illness, Freddie Mercury managed earlier this year to finish his final record. The show must go on.